The other one that I think is really interesting is a lot of people cannot make decisions based on the data because they don't have context. One of the most wonderful things about the internet is that if you're half competent at your business, all your web analytics numbers go up and to the right over time. Even server errors go up and to the right over time. So if that's the reality of the world, how do you make decisions? And I think people can't make good decisions on their data because they don't have context. And context is extremely important. So for example, rather than looking at one solitary number, you can actually get a nice performance overview. So you can say how many page views are there, how long are people spending, what's the exit rate, get a dollar index, sweet. But what is actually better is no matter where you go in Google Analytics, by default, the team is trying to give you context from your data. In this case, if you look at this trip, it's actually telling you, it's comparing the numbers to site averages and actually giving you a hint of where you should be focusing on. And that's very nice. You get this by default. In most reports in Google Analytics, you get context. So you no longer have to worry about is that good or bad. It's giving you an initial indication that you're doing kind of okay over there. But the nice thing is it's extremely easy for you to go in and say, I want to compare two different time periods. I want to compare this June in this year to June in last year. I want to compare this week to last week, last 3 months to the 3 months before. And that gives you even more specific context for yourself. In this case, I'm comparing May and June. Simple. This is the dumbest thing to do. Compare two different months. Am I doing better or worse? For in this particular case, whoa, that's kind of nice. I got 300% more page views on the website. And look, I kind of did not suck. Context is the thing. Very quickly, you open a report, you look at it, you have an idea if you're doing well or not. But there is also one other subtle difference between these three things. When you show most senior executives the first strip of data, just this data, with no context, the question that they ask you is, what is the definition of time on page? Because they have no idea if the number is good or bad. So tell me how you captured the data. A useless conversation, by the way. If you give them these two pieces of data, nobody cares about what the definition is. You know where you're good and where you're not good. And it moves the conversation along farther quickly. And that's what you want to do. You don't want to argue about things that are not important. You can do this in your tools. You can do this in Excel if you want, right? Very simple strategies in which you can give context to your data so you can actually make decisions from it rather than arguing about what the definition is. Here's another way, right? This is nice. Everybody wants to make money. You can set up your goals. If you don't have goals in Google Analytics, that's very suboptimal. I'm a huge fan. There's like a whole chapter in the book that talks about how outcomes are very important. If you don't know what the outcomes of your website are, no amount of analysis will tell you what you should be doing. So goals are good. Sometimes you mess up and you create a goal that you don't want to track anymore, then it's fine. But create goals. And the nice thing is you can say, oh, I see conversions. It kind of sort of looks like it's going up. But I do the same exact thing, compare two different time periods. I get a much better read on performance. Not doing so well over here, doing a little bit better over here. Right? Very, very simple trick, but it gives you context to your data. Exact same thing here. Isn't it more fun to know that you're up 7% rather than knowing you got a million visits on your website? Like, who cares about the absolute number? What's more important is to move the conversation along. Same thing here, search keywords. Where are the people coming from? What traffic sources are working better for me? Very, very easy for you to understand. One of my new principles, you know, PETA, People Like for Ethical Treatment of Animals. That's a great organization. And so I came up with a new acronym, and it's called PALM, P-A-L-M. And it stands for People Against Lonely Metrics. And the reason I say that is because lots of people look at one number by itself. We all want a husband and a wife and a girlfriend and boyfriend. Maybe all of them at the same time. by the way, that's this screenshot. But if you want to make effective decisions in the data, always find a best friend for your for whatever metric you're trying to track. If page views is what you're trying to drive at, find the best possible metric that would give you context to the data that allows you to take action. In this case, for me personally, I want to know what pages are important. Actually, this is much more important. So I know what stories are more important to people, what people react to, so I can write more. If I did not look at this metric, the boyfriend metric, the girlfriend metric might be telling me something wrong. So for your metrics, as you analyze the data, never ever on any dashboard or report look at one metric by itself. It will not give you the kind of insight you need to take action that will impact your bottom line. And the nice thing is there are a couple different ways to do it. Is this good or bad? I can make some judgments. But if you want to short circuit the time it takes to make the decision, click one more button and you get this. Now this is a wonderful view, exactly the same data, exact same metrics. But now it's comparing performance of every page in time outside to average amount of time people spend on your website. And this is very cool because now I don't even have to think. I can say, oh, cool, 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 suck, suck, suck. Very, very easy. You can do this anywhere. I'm not getting impressive with animations, right? But you can do this anywhere you want. It's very easy for you to find a best friend for your metric that allows you to find define performance. And then it's very easy for you to identify where you need to be paying attention. All in two clicks. Exact same thing, right? Everybody here loves search. So you can look at all your search data for goals, outcomes, exactly the same thing. Which search engine is more important? In this case, if I want to drive conversion, actually Yahoo seems to be more important than Google. Although Google brings a stunning more amount of traffic. So you can balance your strategy, but it gives you insight. Exact same view. But now, comparing to site average, drives action. The wonderful thing about the difference between this graph and this is the same one that I had mentioned before. In this case, people try to understand data. And some analysts amongst you want to try and spend time understanding data. This is what you send to your senior management. They should not spend time understanding data. They should be making decisions. And it's easy if you look at this view for it to be accretive to driving decisions quickly.